whenever in quantum mechanics you are having a wave function, that wave function you cannot utilize unless and until you find the normalization constant. So for our wave function, for sine of x0, we will have to find the normalization constant A. So to find the normalization constant, you know the normalization condition from minus infinity to plus infinity, psi mod square dx will be equal to 1. And this is implies that in our case it is from 0 to A. Because our wave function is defined from 0 to A only. And then the conjugate of this one and the plane, this one. So is no iota is involved, so we can directly square this thing. So it will be A squared and x squared A minus x whole square dx is equal to 1. So we can write that what this integral will be equal to. Can you solve this integral?
Yes.
It is not that difficult, because this will be a squared from 0 to a, and then x squared into a squared plus x squared minus 2ax dx, and this is equal to 1, and this will give you, means a square x square, you will do this, so it will become a x cube by 3, x cube by 3 this one, and so on. So you can solve this integral, and it will give you a equals 30 over a 5 square root. This is the normalization constant. So now I will start with this one, and it is equal Cn. Now Cn is equal to 2 over A, and then for this one I will write the value of A here. So the value of A will be 30 by A 5 square root, and then 0 to A and sine n pi x over A, and psi x0 will become x into A minus x dx. The A with this one, so I have written it here. Now my equation is ready, that I do integrate this one. And what will be this integration? You are having this one. If I write like this, then I want to simplify this one first, and to simplify this one, multiply this one here. So it will be a times x, and then it will be x squared. So when it will be a times x, and the other will be, and this will be with sine of x, for example, and then plus it will be x squared a sine of x. Now, the very first thing I told you, that whenever you solve an integral, the first thing you will have to do is to the R-Truman test. Look here. Here is x and here is sine x. This is an odd function, x. And this one is also an odd function. Odd and odd will multiply and will give you even thing, right? So this one will be non-zero. This will be non-zero. But what about this one? This is an even function, and this is an odd function, and this will give you zeros. Right? This is non-zero. So you will only get this one when you will split this integral, and your integral will come out to be cn is equal to 4 n 15 by n pi cubed. And this will be, the integral will give you the cos of 0 and cos of n pi. Okay. When you will put the limits from 0 to a here, because this is sine, you will do some supposition, the book will guide you further. And after that supposition, when you will find the integral, it will term, come out in terms of cos of x. So cos 0 and cos n phi. You know that cos 0 is equal to 1. And here, this term will be decided by the value of n. And n will be odd. Then cos phi will be equal to minus 1. And 1 minus minus 1 will come 2 here. If n will be even, this will come out to be cos plus 1. So it will be 0. So we can write that this thing will be equal to 0 if n is even. And this will be equal to 8 multiplied by 15 square root divided by n pi cubed if n is odd. So you found the value of cn. Once you find that value, you can just apply it on your wave function here. This is the value to cn, and you can write that your sine x of t, this is capital sine, will be equal to 30 by a after simplification and 2 over pi, and this is 3 summation on n. Now you know that this summation on n was running from 1 to infinity. Now we will exclude the even values. Like not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 3, 5. Because for even it will give 0. So only the odd values are included. So I will write 1, 3, 5 and so on up to infinity. And 1 over n cubed. Sine means all this will come, and when this sine n pi x over a, and the e portion will be minus i over h bar minus I over multiplied with t by h bar and en. So En, you know that what is En? N square pi square h bar square, n square pi square h bar square by 2m a square. This will come out to be the wave function of means the wave started in this form, like this is the state of a particle at time t equal to 0. You put this particle into infinite square well, and you want to see what happens to the state of the particle after time t. So after time t, the particle's state will become like this. Clear? Now you see that the infinite square well is playing its role in it. You calculated Cn in terms of the infinite square well, right? And you got that the wave function will be like this. Clear?
Similarly, there is example 2.3 as well. So what example 2.3 is telling you? In example 2.2, the starting wave function closely resembles the ground state Ψ1. This suggests C1 square should dominate, and in fact means the wave function that we used in example 2.2, this is example 2.3, and it says that the wave function you used in example 2.2, what was the shape of the wave function? The shape of the wave function was like this, you remember, 0 to a, and this value was a square into a square over 4. Now from this wave function, you see that it seems that the first wave, the first state of infinite square wave, because only one cycle, means half of a cycle, like one crest. In the very first state of infinite square wave, we were having such a shape. So it means that in all CNs, in all CNs, the C1 will be actually the dominant term. When we will expand the wave function, this wave function, or psi x of 0, then the dominant coefficient will be this one. While C2, C3, C4, they will have very, very small magnitude. Because the wave shape is like this. So it means it resembles with the very first one. And now the problem is actually saying you that this resembles the ground state of infinite square wave. This suggests that C1 square should be the dominating term. If I find C1, I have calculated here. What is C1? Cn here is equal to 815 by pi n cube, right? Now n should be odd only. So what about C1? C1 is 815 over pi cube. Now what about C1 mod square? I will square Cn is equal to 815 over pi n from there. So if I find C1, then n is equal to 1 and I am having this. If I mod square this one, it is equal to this. So you see, this is almost 0.1. Some very, very less magnitude is remaining. So I see that summation on n Cn mod square will be equal to 1. This is equal to C1 square plus C2 square plus C3 square plus C4 square plus and so on are all equal to 1. Now in this situation, we are not having the contribution from all even. So C1 square plus C3 square plus C5 square and so on is equal to 1. This one, we calculated that this is 0.99855 plus. So it means the contribution from this one and all the rest of the odd terms will be equal if you subtract one from one this one. So this contribution is 0.00 something. Like, let's say 0.001 for example. Mainly this term is dominant, this coefficient is dominant, rest of the coefficients are very, very small. So the problem is telling you this thing, that rest of the coefficients are very, very small. That's why the wave function is resembling only, this is C1.
Right? The wave function is resembling this thing. Now what about the other terms? The footnote of the book has explained this thing, that anything 1 over 1 to the power 6, 1 over 3 to the power 6, 1 over 5 to the power 6,
1 over 1 to the power 6 plus 1 over 5, 3 to the power 6 and 1 over 5 to the power 6 and so on. This is equal to pi to the power 6 by 960. If you calculate this one,
pi 6 divided by 960,
this one is approximately 961 and this is 960. So all these terms means C5, this is for 1, C this one, 1 over 3, 6, 1 over this one, all will add up in the sum of such a series is 961 by 960, which is very, very less than 1. So all the other terms when add up, they will contribute very, very less, because this one is not ending, this one is having some more terms. When you want that the sum should be equal to 1, it means there are some other terms as well, but the contribution from other terms is very, very less, and this one is the dominant term, right?
So this example is actually signifying you this thing. And when you will calculate the expectation value of energy here, then it will be,
means the energy is given in terms here, En. So put n equal to 1 and calculate this energy.